Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are doing well and staying healthy during this crazy season. In a time filled with so much uncertainty, it is so important to rest in the Lord every single day. So that's why I am sharing with you my quiet time routine. This has been my routine throughout the year, and it is my personal time with the Lord. I definitely don't expect everyone to have a carbon copy of these specific practices, but I do really want to encourage you to find both a routine and resources that make you excited to get into God's Word every single day and bring some sort of sweet normalcy into these dark times. I don't know about you, but I have to really focus my heart in to prepare to read God's Word. I have a 10-month-old little girl, and whenever my mind just wants to be on what her day will look like and all of those things, I really just have to do something in order to get my mind focused on what the Lord would have to teach me. So most days I turn on just one worship song and I open my notebook and write and pray, asking God to open the eyes of my hearts to what He would have to speak to me through what He has already spoken in His Word. This year, I've been using the Read Bible app by the Bible Project for my scripture reading plan. They have put together a plan that goes straight through the Bible and then ends each day with a psalm. They also have a little video on a lot of days that just gives some explanation of context and what we're reading. I open my app, check what I'm reading for that day, and then jump right into scripture. One of my greatest encouragements to you would be to just read the text starting off before you go to any outside sources. Annotate and underline the things that you love. Draw a cross by the things that point you to Jesus. Put a question mark by what you don't understand. Just whatever helps you process. Then I typically go to the podcast, The Bible Recap, and scroll to whatever podcast goes with my reading for that day. It does tend to line up pretty closely with the specific plan that I'm doing right now, which is really helpful. This podcast is awesome because it really quickly breaks down a lot of the context of the passages that I'm reading, and then it shows where God's character is consistent throughout all of the scriptures. After I pray through what I just learned, I open up the Dwell app. It's an audio Bible app that plays scripture from different versions and then reads through with different voices with music playing in the background. It's really awesome. I scroll to a psalm and then head outside and listen to the psalm of the day over and over and over again. You can actually set the app to just repeat the scripture time after time and then leave some time for reflection in between. I love this time of my quiet time. I get to go outside every morning, stretch, and just let the psalms wash over me. I typically pick out one verse or phrase to just dwell on throughout the day. And that's my quiet time. I try to spend a minimum of 40 minutes, ideally an hour, doing this. And then Austin goes to get Eden up for the day and brings her down so that she can nurse. For me, the trick is going to bed at a decent hour so that I can wake up with ample time to commit to being in God's Word before she gets up for the day. One thing that I've learned is that my routines with this quiet time, they will change with seasons. They'll ebb and flow, and that's okay. There's all kinds of grace, and it's never too late to start. So, what are your quiet time routines? I would love for you to comment below and let me know how you're communing with God each day. Who knows, I might add something that you suggest into my quiet time. Especially through this season of quarantine, it's just really important to encourage one another. So I hope that this has served you and encouraged you in your time with the Lord right now.